Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am doing the mom thing today in the office. We can literally see Clara asleep in the background. But I just wanted to intro this video for you really quick before you start to see the Photoshop tutorial. You're gonna be learning not only how to swap a head in a group photo, but change the direction of someone's eyes, which can really come in handy as wedding photographers when we take a lot of group photos. And not everybody's looking always. So this is a game changer. I hope that you guys learned something and enjoy this video style. If you enjoy this style of video and you wanna see more, Anthony is willing to come back and make this a series, so please leave your Photoshop suggestions in the comment section below. I'll see you guys as usual over in the Photo Boss Facebook group, and of course, I'll see you next week. Bye guys.
Hello everyone, my name is Anthony Bolognese. I am a fashion, lifestyle, and event photographer, and from what everybody in my photography network keeps telling me, I'm pretty good at Photoshop. So today we're going to be taking one of Joy's wedding photos and using it to show how you can replace the face of somebody in a group photo, so long as you have another face of theirs to choose from. In this image, the bridesmaid on the far right blinked. And this is a super common occurrence in group photos like this. What might not be super common is that this is the only other image we have from this setting to take that face from, and she's looking off to her left. So you guys are in for some work today. We're first going to use our quick selection tool and select her new face and hair from the other image. I would rather select too much and trim it down instead of just selecting the face and having to redo the process to take more information from the new photo. Once I've done that, I'll go to the select menu up top and click invert, or hit command shift I if you're into shortcuts and on a Mac. And that'll select everything else from this image other than what I just chose out of her face and hair. I'll try to hit delete, and then remember that I need to rasterize the layer, because I never ever ever remember to rasterize until Photoshop reminds me that I have to. So now I'm left with a floating head, but at least her eyes are open. I'll shimmy that around until I'm happy with the rough placement, and I'll get to work on her eyes. Very quickly, before I do that, I'll take the eraser brush and just kind of clean up the edges of her head, clean up the hair, and make it a little bit less poofy. For this part, we're going to try the quick selection tool again, but the program's brain wants to select too much, so let's go with the lasso tool, just for more precision. We'll select the iris of one of her eyes, and then move it over so that she's looking at us now. After we've got that centered, we notice that this dead space exists where her iris used to be. No worries, we'll just select our brush tool, hold Alt, and click on the remaining whites of her eye, and then use that color to fill in the other side. There will be a lot of color selecting and brushing to basically paint her eye socket back to life and make it so that the pixel gradient isn't visible when zoomed out. As you can see, during this process, there's a lot of hard edges, and that's something that you're going to want to take care of. So you want that gradient to be nice and smooth, but you still want there to be a rough jump between the iris and the white of her eyes. Now, as hilarious as it would be to say we're done now, it's time to do the same thing to the other eye. Lasso tool, brush, pick your colors, and paint your way to direct eye contact. As I mentioned, the softer you can get that gradient between her iris and the whites of her eyes, the more convincing this Photoshop job will look. It's not going to look like there's so many hard edges, and it's not going to look Photoshopped. I'm taking a decent chunk of time to make sure that the shape of her iris is correct, as well as that gradient. I don't want there to be any too dark spots or too light spots. Now that we've done that and zoomed out, I realize that I kind of overcompensated, and now she's looking a little bit too far to the right. I very easily could have just cut the first part out where I messed up, but Photoshop work can be the most tedious part of the photography process, and I don't want anybody to be discouraged about not getting it right the first try. I've been doing this for 5 years, I still get it wrong just like this. So that's just something that is a reality in the life of a photographer, especially someone who chooses to actually edit their photos in this way. So it's the same process again. We'll lasso each iris once more, adjust it a tiny bit back to the right, and get her looking at us. Some people abide by the mentality that perfect is the enemy of good. I only believe that in certain circumstances. Photoshop is not one of those circumstances. So perfection is definitely something that I strive for. Zooming out and viewing the photo from its full 100% perspective, the way the client is actually going to be seeing it, is the greatest gauge of perfection for me. So if there's anything that I see wrong, looking at it at its full size, I know that my job's not done. Now, once you zoom out to 100%, you can't see any of those little details. Switching back and forth between the two, I do notice that I've also added a lot of volume to her hair, which is an accidental bonus. I'm sure she'll be happy about that. I do realize that I'm not super happy with the placement of her head now. So now that the eye detail is done, I can work on the larger scale issues with her hair and the alignment of her skin between the two versions of her head and kind of work on those details. So I'll take the eraser brush and kind of paint out those details, get the more of her chest showing, feature that little necklace that she has on, and kind of clean up those edges. The little blurriness below her ear, I'll erase all that and kind of clean up that edge. I want to make sure that the earring is still distinguishable. I also want to click the smudge tool and kind of blend the skin tone just between the shadows in those two versions of that image. So looking back between the two, I see a little bit more of an issue with her hair just on the right there. So I'm going to go in and take care of that with the eraser tool once more. And as soon as that is smoothed out, I believe this image to be done. And just like that, in about 10 minutes of real-time editing, we've gone from a blooper to a sellable image. So thank you for watching. Again, my name is Anthony Bolognese, and if you like this tutorial, check out my channel, Anthony Bolognese, where I take requests for tutorials and will edit your photos in a video just like this, just to show you how to do it yourself. I also provide Photoshop editing services like this for other photographers who are too busy or don't yet know how to do it themselves. I want to thank Joy again for having me create this video for her channel. If you want to see more content like this, leave her a comment and let her know. I love doing it. I love fixing people's photos and kind of teaching them how to make the most out of the images that they've created. Thanks, guys, and I hope to see you again soon.
When are you going to start Photoshopping for me? You got to start pulling your weight around here someday, right? You can be my in-house Photoshopper. Deal. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please excuse my messy office and inability to record myself without a tripod. Share inside the comment section what you'd like to learn in Photoshop, because Anthony is willing to come back, make more tutorials. What would be most helpful for you guys? Throw it in the comment section below, and I'll see you next week.